मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड न्यू लेसन, दैट इज मटेरियल्स, मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. ओके, वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स, एंड मे बी यू हैव रिटन इन योर नोटबुक ऑल्सो दैट ऑल नोट्स. सी, सो टूडे वी विल स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स. सो बिफोर टू स्टार्ट दिस actual point, chemical properties of metals, before vacation I given you notes in the PDF form. Okay, in that this reactivity series are given. This is very important to for this. Okay, so this reactivity series, and see here I written some symbols also: potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, nickel, lead, copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. See, here is not all metals are written. Here some metals are written, those are reactive, mostly reactive with others. Okay, so potassium, this is the reactivity series. We see potassium, sodium and calcium. What is the symbol of potassium? This is very important that all notes you have to refer and see each symbol of each metal. Okay, because this is very important for the chemical reaction. So that time we are not writing this name potassium. We will just mention this symbol K. So by heart these all symbols and names. Okay, this reactivity series, see here, potassium, sodium and calcium, very highly reactive metals. These three metals are very highly reactive, means if you will keep in an open space it starts burning. So mostly this sodium, you know that sodium and potassium we kept in a kerosene. Why? Because it is highly reactive with oxygen and water, and you know that in our surrounding the many gases are present, in that oxygen it is there. Okay, so if you will keep it outside it start burning. So because of that we kept these highly reactive metal in a kerosene. Okay, so these three are very highly reactive metals. This is very important because one more reaction is there, that is the displacement reaction. That time this reactivity series is important for you. Okay, now see, then magnesium, aluminium. Magnesium, what is the symbol of magnesium? Mg. Aluminium, Al. Zinc, Zn. Iron, Fe. Nickel, Ni. And lead, Pb. See, now these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These 6 metals are less reactive metals. Means they are reacting, but these are the less reactive than these metals. Okay, these, now magnesium. Magnesium, feed, you know that. Okay, last year also we did the experiment. Okay, so these you can keep in open space because it is not highly reactive like this potassium, sodium and calcium. Okay, so this is the less reactive metal. And at last, finally, that is copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. These are least reactive. Least means what? See, this is the less reactive and these are the least reactive, means mostly they are reactive. Or see here, the last gold, platinum and silver, they are, if you will say it is a non-reactive, even though it's okay because they are not taking part in a reaction. Okay, so we are wearing jewelries that is made up of the silver, gold and platinum. Okay, because they are non-reactive, means least reactive metals. Okay, so these reactivity series write down in your chemistry notebook, and this reactivity series you have to by heart it. Okay, so highly reactive metals, see, potassium, sodium, calcium, these three metals are very highly reactive. Then these less reactive, and last these are least reactive metals. Okay, so now we will start our actual point, that is the chemical properties of metals. Okay, so in this chemical properties of metals, first we will see, that is the reaction of metals with oxygen. Now all the metals, okay, what is the reaction, means what happened when they come contact with oxygen. So this we will see. most of the metals combine with oxygen to form metal oxide. Means whenever metals react with oxygen, then they form metal oxides. Okay, they see here I have written some examples. Mg means magnesium. When magnesium is reacted with oxygen, it forms 2MgO. Now MgO means magnesium oxide. Means whenever metals are react with oxygen, it forms metal oxide. See, magnesium oxide means sodium you can take. So whenever any react with oxygen, it will form sodium oxide. So most of the metals, see, most of the metals combine with oxygen to form metal oxides. Then see, metal oxides are basic in nature. See, metal oxides are basic in nature. Now in acid base, in last year we learned that what is a base, what is acids. Okay, so metals oxide are basic in nature. Alkalis, that is water soluble bases. Now to whom we have to say the alkalis? See, alkalis means what? Those are soluble in water. Okay, or it is hot in water. Water soluble bases are known as a alkalis. This word is very important. Means now further when we will do the more study in that, directly we are using the alkali word. So alkali means what? Alkali means the water soluble base. Now base, that acid and base, in that lesson we learn. Okay, so alkali is water soluble bases. So when these metal oxides, see, metal oxides plus water, if you will add in that metal oxide water, it will form a base. And how to test it is a basic in nature. You take a litmus paper, okay? If red litmus paper will turn blue, means it means it is basic in nature. And blue litmus remains as it is. That is, means it is base, okay? So mostly metals when react with oxygen, it form metal oxides. And metal oxides plus water, it form a base. Okay, here I give one example. Mg plus O2, it gives 2MgO. Now here two number to balance this reaction. Okay, and when in magnesium oxide, when you will add the water, see, it will form a magnesium hydroxide. See here OH is there. OH, in last year we learned hydroxide means OH group. It is a basic thing. Okay, magnesium hydroxide. Now this we will see with practical. Means now we will take one magnesium ribbon, it will burn and then we will get the magnesium oxide, and when we will add in water in that, then magnesium hydroxide will be. Okay, and some examples we will see now. See, this is a magnesium ribbon. Okay, this magnesium ribbon is burning with white flame, and now here collected, that is a magnesium oxide. You know that for the burning, oxygen is essential. Okay, are you able to see this white magnesium oxide? Now what we will do, we will add in this little amount of water. Okay, see here, I written magnesium oxide plus water, it gives magnesium hydroxide. So now here magnesium hydroxide is formed, and you just check it with litmus paper. Okay, because it is basic in nature. See, this is a blue litmus paper. It is moist blue litmus paper. Now moist means what? Before test, we just have to dip in water. And now check this, really it is basic in nature or not. See, I dip in this solution. This is, see, here any change? No, blue litmus paper remain as it is. Means what? It is basic in nature. Okay, do you understand this? This practical already we done last year also. So whenever metals are reacted. See, metals are reacted with oxygen. Okay, so that time it formed magnesium. Magnesium oxide reacted with water and it formed magnesium hydroxide, and it is basic in nature. And this magnesium hydroxide is known as a alkali. Why? Because it is water soluble base. Okay, now there's some more examples. We will see how the metals are reacted with oxygen. Okay, these all points you write down in your chemistry notebook. This reactivity series also and this points. Now we will see next examples. Before first example, we learn about the magnesium. Okay, magnesium react with oxygen, magnesium oxide, and when it's reacted with water, it form magnesium hydroxide. Now the second example, see, sodium is a metal. Sodium metal when react with oxygen, it form Na2O. Means what? Sodium oxide. Here I written names. Okay, and again this sodium oxide react with water, then it form a Na2OH. Means okay, sodium hydroxide. Now NaOH, you know, sodium hydroxide. One more example, that is aluminium react with oxygen, it gives aluminium oxide. Okay, you write here names, then you will understood. Aluminium plus oxygen, it gives aluminium oxide. Next chemical properties we will learn in next lecture. Thank you.